Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. Now you can get a free sneak peek into Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery membership program. The details are in the description box below this video. In this video, you will learn how to embed your fonts in PowerPoint. I've seen cases where some of the presenters have downloaded some fancy fonts from the net, and they use those fonts to beautify their slides. What they do is, once they finish creating their slide deck, they save the slide presentation onto a thumb drive, go to the boardroom, load their presentation onto the computer or laptop available in the boardroom, and they start their presentation. And that is when they face a rude shock. They would see that the fancy fonts that they had used to make their presentation slide deck look really gorgeous is now replaced by some other random fonts by PowerPoint. What is worse, the slide deck really looks jumbled and messy because you would see that some of the sentences overflow into multiple lines or some of the words overlap with each other because of the new fonts that have replaced the fancy fonts that you had used in the original presentation. So how do you avoid this mess? How do you avoid the embarrassment of seeing your own slide deck look all jumbled and messed up because the computer you use to project from doesn't have the fonts that you have in your own computer? The answer is to embed your fonts in PowerPoint. Yes, PowerPoint allows you the option to embed the fonts in your PowerPoint presentation so that wherever you project your presentation from, you would see that your presentation will have all the fancy fonts that you've used in your original presentation. The option to embed your fonts is very easy to find. What you need to do is to go to File, go all the way down to Options, and this dialog box opens up, and there you go to Save option, and here down you can see this option called Embed Fonts in the File. You check that. Now here you have two options. One is whether you want to embed only the characters used in the presentation. This is the option that you would use if you don't want anyone else to edit your presentation. This obviously should be your preferred choice, and this is also the right choice when you want your file size to be reduced. The other option you have is embed all characters. This is the right choice if you want your presentation to be edited by someone else, and the fancy fonts that you had used in your presentation will still be retained, and the other person would be able to edit your presentation easily because all the characters are embedded in the presentation. So you select this or this, depending on your requirement. But realize that when you embed all characters, your file size will bloat up, and it'll take a little longer for you to save your file. Whereas if you choose to embed only the characters, then the file size will be smaller. So that is how you embed fonts in your file. Once you've checked that option, you say OK, and now your presentation is saved with all the fonts, and you can go to the boardroom with full confidence that your slides will look exactly the way you had designed them originally. I hope you really liked this useful tip. Hey, are you looking for an easy to follow, comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training online? Do you want to learn how to create beautiful picture slides like this, chart slides like this, infographics like this, 3D graphics like this, or in general beautiful slides like this, this, or this? Then please join our Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery membership program. It is arguably the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training online. You get instant access to more than 650 step-by-step video tutorials, more than 225 text-based lessons, and more than 400 downloadable files the moment you join Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery membership program. You can sign up for a free sneak peek into the program right away. Please click here to watch a few of the premium videos from the program for free right now. I'll see you inside the program.